Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. So in this video, we are going to learn about how we can create a typewriting animation in an iOS application development. So basically, a typewriting animation is an animation in which text is coming as we are typing something with some sound. So this is really very cool. We can see these kind of animations in movies or in short films or films, whatever kind of videos we see on YouTube or in the cinemas also. So we are going to learn this thing in this video. So let's look into the demo first. So this is the demo in which we are seeing a simple white screen. So as I tap anywhere on the screen, we are getting this cool animation with a cool sound. So this animation can be used anywhere where you want to show label. Apart from that, I've also started working on Flutter. So if you want to learn iOS and Flutter, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and subscribe the channel. And if you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Share the video, let's create an app. So open an Xcode, click on single view application, click on next. Just give the whatever name you want to give. I'm just giving type animation and be sure the language should be Swift. Click on next and create this project where you want to create. After creating of this project, let's move to the storyboard and design as basic label. You can also design this thing by via coding. So just drag and drop one label over here. And just give a basic constraint to this label. It's up to you what constraints you want to give. I'm just giving 2020 from the trailing and leading, and center horizontal and vertical. Now let's change some properties for this label. Just like let's make it center and increase the font size of this label like this. And let's change the color for this label to this one. So this is looking cool, and just remove the text over here like this. Now let's move to the view controller and create one label outlet for this label. So that is text label, something like this. And now let's create one gesture. So whenever user tap on view, so then this animation will perform. If you will try to make this animation on view did load, it will not work because this is using some kind of a run loop, so it will not allow run loops to run on the view did load. So you can use this thing for view did appear, that thing. Now let's add a tap gesture for this thing. So let gesture only gesture is equals to UI tap gesture recognizer, and in this we have to use self selector is just like hash selector kind of a thing. In this we have to write the name of the method on click view, something like this. Now add this gesture on the view self.view.addGestureRecognizer. In this we have to use gesture like this. Now add this method which we have defined over add. So for that we need to use @objc function. Just copy this thing, be sure the name will be same on both the things. So we have defined a tap gesture. So whenever user tap on anywhere on the screen, it will call this method. In this method, we have to define a basic logic. So before proceeding further, first we have to take a string, so that on which string we have to perform this typing animation. So I'm just defining a where str is equal to in double quotes. We have to use let create an app, something like this. Now we need to use a loop on this label. So for that, first we have to use for i in str. So this will run a loop that how many characters in that str, so it will work on that thing. Now we have to add this i in the label. So for adding that thing, we have to use text label dot text is equals to i. So by doing this thing, I guess it will show an error. Yeah, definitely, because text label dot text is a kind of a string and it will accept strings, and I is a character, so it will not work in this thing condition. So first we have to make using it to work this thing. So let's put this thing in double quotes and place this question mark and something like this. So now it will work, and because we have made this thing a string, but still I is a simple character. So first it will come and put L, then E, then T. So we can do this thing. Let's check and run this thing and then we will check that it is working or not. For me, it will not work. We need to put a plus sign to make this work. So yeah, that's exactly what I'm thinking, that it will work something like this. So let's place plus over here. So whatever thing in the text label dot text, then it will add I in that value. So for first time it will L, and the next time it's E. So it will append L and E, and the next time that is T, and it will append L E T. So this is the scenario which we will follow. So after adding plus, we will get one error, that is, it is kind of a string optional. So we need to make we have to forcefully wrap this thing. So till so far we have done. Now we have to add a basic logic to perform a typing animation. So for performing typing animation, we are using run loop. So basically, run loop is a mechanism by which we can stop the execution of a code for a specific period of time, which we pass in that run loop argument. So just simply look run loop dot current dot run loop, and in this date parameter we have defined the specific time: 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 1 second, 0.4 second. So it's up to you what time you want to pass, and it will stop the execution for that specific period of time. So I'm just simply using a current time. So by doing this thing, we are getting a current type, and I'm just adding this adding in the current time, and that is 0.20. So it will stop the execution for 0.20 seconds, something like this. Now let's run and check that it is working fine or not. So simulator is run. Now let's tap anywhere on the screen, and it is coming as we have shown. But there are two things which are missing. That is the label. This animation is very slow, a little bit slow, and the sound is not coming. So for making this animation a little bit faster, we have to change the timing over here, and that is, you can put any timing. I'm just putting 1 to 12. And for getting the sound, we have to first import the AV Foundation kit. AV Foundation, and for getting a sound, we have to use a inbuilt library or inbuilt system sounds for that typing animation. So for using the inbuilt sound or system sounds, we have to use audio service place system sound. Yeah, this one. And in this, we have to pass the ID. So let's close this thing and let's move to the view controller only, so we can learn properly. And we need to pass a system sounds over here. So there are hundreds of system sounds in the iPhone. So we can get the system sound defaultly by just providing the ID in this block. So let's look these system sounds. So this is a URL on which I am getting all these system sounds. So these are the IDs which we can pass and try different system sounds on our system. The link of this URL is in the description. You can go and check it out. And I'm using this 1306, this one, talk.caf. And this will give a better typing animation effect or sound in the system. So 1306, so this one works very well. So let's run and check that it is working fine or not. So our simulator is run. Now let's click. So it is coming perfectly fine, and with the sound also. Maybe the sound is not synchronized because it's not coming in my system, because I'm using mic for this thing, and this is not a bi-directional thing. So you can try this thing in your system, and the sound will definitely come as you see in the demo. So this is for today. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you want to learn iOS application development and Flutter development, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button also. Share the video. And if you have any query or suggestion, please let me know about the thing by posting a comment in the comment box. And if you want any specific functionality, please let me know about the thing by putting a comment in the comment section. So this is for today. Thank you.